second I die, I'm with my Savior. I'm with my Lord. Oh, death, where is thy sting? You have no sting, no power over me anymore, death. For all those outside of Christ, I would certainly hope that there is a fear of death. And I hope that fear of death drives you to the Savior, drives you to the only one who had power over death, and power over sin, and power over the devil. Jesus Christ, and he cries out, he commands you to repent today, to turn from sin, to trust in him, to throw your life away for him, to cry out to him, to fall at his feet, to cry out for Christ to have mercy on you today.
What about those that don't believe, though? What about those that don't believe but believe in higher life forms? Like, why does the Catholic Church say there are higher life forms? Why does it talk about it on history about higher life forms? On History Channel.
This is the one book, sir, by which
it's not.
Why, based on what you say there?
Huh?
Based on whose authority do you say this is not the word of God?
I base it on the historians. How's that?
Why would you listen to a man other than God? Over God.
Because God doesn't talk to you.
He talks right here. It's in his word.
Not to me.
Yeah, he don't.
No, he don't. Sorry, I believe in the aliens.
No, you don't. That's confusing.
I believe in other life forms.
Can I go out on a limb and say,
I believe in a creator, but I don't believe in God.
Let me ask you, you're aliens that
you believe in a creator, but I don't believe in a God. I believe in a creator, but I don't believe in a God. Jesus Christ was a man. Jesus Christ was a man. But was he from here?
Does your creator hold you accountable?
Was Jesus Christ from here? Was Jesus Christ from here?
Listen, sir, if you don't want to talk, I'm trying to ask you a question. Does your creator hold you accountable for sin? Does he care? Does he care? See, that sounds like a really convenient God that you've made up in your own mind. One that doesn't care about what you do.
No, I believe
one that doesn't care about how you live.
I believe we were the first engineered by the alien race from another galaxy. How's that?
Well, sir, you know you don't believe that.
Yes, I do.
But it's convenient because it allows you to let you sin. See, that kind of God allows you to keep sinning, so it's convenient to believe it, right, ma'am? Is that right, ma'am? That's convenient, sir.
One quick question.
Yes, sir.
Are you a vegan?
A vegan?
Yes, sir.
No, sir. I thought about
it. Can you attend? Christ was a vegan. Have a great day.
He was. He ate fish. Christ ate fish.
No, that is tofu fish.
Where did you get that from, bro?
He made it out of tofu.
That's a first.
It's in the Bible.
That's a first. Is it in the Bible?
Tofu.
You have a chapter and verse I can look at?
I don't read it. Look up tofu in the Bible.
It's not in the Bible. What's your point, though, sir? Have you been born again?
I've been born about 4,000 times.
Have you been born again?
What does that mean?
Has God given you a new heart so that you love Him, desire Him?
I don't understand what you're talking about.
Do you see the beauty of Christ today?
Pardon?
Do you love Jesus Christ?
I don't know Jesus Christ.
So you haven't been born again?
What does that mean?
That means, that's what I'm saying. When God comes in, He gives you a new heart so that the Christ that you hate today, you love.
How can you hate somebody?
The sin that you love today, you hate.
How can you hate somebody you don't know?
You do know, sir. You know, He's Lord of the universe.
You're putting words into Him. I said I don't know.
You know, He's Lord of the universe.
Which is? Well, Rabbi Merrill over here might want to have a conversation.
Yeah, I would love to. We already trusted. Oh, is that Rabbi?
That's Rabbi Merrill.
I would ask Rabbi, same thing I'd ask you. Who's going to pay for your sin when you stand before God?
I don't believe that that's a possibility.
Sure you do. Sure you do.
I do know, sir.
Yeah, you're in denial.
Denial.
Yeah, every sinner, see, they hide behind something.
You come up with an excuse. Saying I'm in denial.
Yeah. No, sir, but you made up an excuse to keep you from coming to Christ, even though you know He's God. And the Bible says it's because you love sin. You're enslaved to sin today. You're enslaved to sin.
Why are you putting words in my mouth?
And so you're doing the deeds of your father, the devil.
You're not even responding to
what
I'm saying.
We're calling you to repent.
You're going into your robot.
We're calling you to repent, sir, to turn from sin.
I feel like I'm talking to a doorknob.
All the vanity that you live for, the sin that you live for today.
Did you vote for Trump?
Turn to Christ.
Mind and throw your Bible at me and see if you can give me a
I would say the same thing to Trump, sir. Repent and believe.
I'm sad, sir. I have compassion for you.
See, that's another excuse, sir.